Qualcomm, Symantec, 23andMe, and iRobot are all firms that started small but are now market leaders, thanks to their innovative technological capabilities. And supporting their growth was the U.S. Small Business Innovation Research Program, or SBIR, which provides active R&D support to small companies and startups. Taking cue from the U.S. program, the Korean government established the Korea Small Business Innovation Research Program in 1998 to drive the growth of Korea's SMEs. Since then, the budget for the R&D grant has continued to mount, nearing the 3 trillion won mark in 2015. Korea is now ahead of Germany and Japan, and is the second largest spender after the US. Thanks to the grant, many of the recipients have been able to strengthen their technological capabilities. However, due to the lack of preceding research, it is unclear what other benefits the grants offer. Accordingly, KDI analyzed the economic gains of Korea's R&D support. A simple comparison was first conducted between recipients and non-recipients based on 10 performance indicators. The results found that recipients overwhelmed their counterparts in terms of operating performance, financing, and capabilities and assets at the time of support. But after 2 or 3 years, the trend reverses, with non-recipients making bigger improvements across the majority of indicators. Next, an examination was conducted on the impact of the grant on corporate growth. The grant enabled companies to secure more funding and expand their investment in all aspects. Unfortunately, this failed to improve the value added, operating profit, and sales. Then, why is the government grant unable to help with the corporate value added? Believing that technological competence generates high growth, the government selects recipients based on this. In fact, compared to the small number of companies with a large number of registered patents, a relatively large share were selected as recipients, and vice versa. And contrary to expectations, the average value added of those with many patents was lower. In addition, the value added of numerous recipients showed an improvement, while that of the majority declined. Those in the lowest decile, in particular, had long histories, large-scale capital, and numerous patent registrations. As such, using a predictive model that is more focused on economic performance than technological competence to select recipients and distribute grants could double the value added.
중소기업 R&D 지원 사업은 그동안 연구 기획과 수혜자 선정을 기술 전문가들에게 주로 의존해 왔습니다. 그 결과 연구 개발 경험이 풍부한 기업들이 수혜를 많이 받고 창업 기업의 초기 연구는 보조금 대신 상환을 요구하는 정책 금융이 주로 담당하는 미스매치가 발생하곤 했습니다. 정부 보조금은 본연의 시드펀드 역할에 충실하게 자금이 충분하지 않은 소규모 기업이 높은 실패 확률을 감수하며 참신한 아이디어를 테스트하는 연구에 지원을 집중해야 부가가치 창출을 극대화할 수 있습니다. 정책 효과 예측 모형을 개발하고 기업 선정 과정에 적용한다면 자금을 나눠주고 관리하는 데 급급한 현재의 시스템에서 벗어나 정부는 중소기업의 체계적인 연구 수행을 돕는 조력자 역할에 더 전념할 수 있을 것입니다.